This is the Oberheim Drummer. It's more than just a simple drum sequencer. It's supposed to be able to have human feel. What this one is doing is it's unresponsive. It should be able to change presets and change MIDI settings. The buttons seem to be doing something, so perhaps something else is going on. So I go ahead and unplug it first. And we're going to remove the four screws on the back of the case. You got these little rubber feet on there too. Yeah, we'll save those for later. So remove the four screws. And once we get those four screws off, there'll be five little screws holding the PCB in place. And for some reason, it still wouldn't come off this point, so I had to figure out why that was. I didn't see any more screws, so what it ended up being is this little plastic overlay. It has cutouts where the residue was holding these chips in place. I noticed this one chip was coming out of the socket, so maybe that could have been the cause of the situation, so I pressed it back in. And once you do that, you might want to go ahead and test it once more. And that's what I did. And also just to show you guys that, hey, you can reset the system and maybe it'll start working again. I've done that before, but I show you again that when you turn it on and you hold those three buttons, it still was unresponsive at this point. Another thing I like to do first is check the battery, make sure it's got a solid 3 volts, which it does. So, another thing, I would like to test these buttons out real quick. So, you just want to find out where the contact points are and then push the button from the other side until it beeps. So, those buttons tested out fine. Now we want to test the voltage regulator. We first need to figure out where the ground pin is, and it's going to be that one there. So we want to plug in the power supply at this point, and then we'll be able to see what kind of voltages are going into this voltage regulator and see what kind of voltage is coming out. So this would be the input pin. We have 9.31 volts going in. That's fine. That's great. Don't short these contacts here. Oh, but we got 7.74 volts. There's the input. And the output, 7.75 volts. That's unacceptable. It should be 5 volts in this case. It's an MC7805. It should be a 5 volt regulator. So we're going to take that puppy out of there. And we're going to replace that with a new one and see if that helps our situation out. The legs on this sucker are bent, so we're going to have to bend the legs on a new one in the same way. Here's the original again. So we need to make sure the spacing of the bend is in this about the same point. So quickly doing that. We'll pop this puppy back in there, then we'll be ready to solder it in place. Make sure that they're the same. Not to confuse the old one, don't solder the old one back in. Oh, I love this soldering iron. It has a light on it, and it heats up really fast. It takes like 30 seconds, and it's hot. It's ready to go and solder. Soldering here. I like to touch the solder against the iron. It heats up a little quicker. At the same time, you want to touch the pin so everything gets heated at the same time, and you want that little cone shape. That's perfect right there. Perfect solder. Now we got to cut those pins up, and at this point we want to make sure those cones show up on the other side. It is a dual-sided PCB, so we want to make sure that solder goes completely through. Okay, plugging back in and powering on. It still says 3.1. I don't know what that means, to be honest. Maybe it's software version. And look, I think I have more controls over this. I can change the pattern. And then I can also change the MIDI settings. And MIDI channel. That's pretty cool. I can't wait to test this thing out. We're going to be testing this thing out before we call it all good, but if it tests out just fine, then I'll be making another demo of that